Commander, we've received a priority signal from the Chapter Honor Guard.
This is Captain Diomedes. All Blood Ravens are to cease crusade recruitment and other operations within the Aurelian sector. Return to your muster points and prepare for mobilization to the Ferox Swift Crusade. Knowledge is power. Guard it well.
He abandons the sector so easily. How can we follow such a man?
We are receiving another priority signal from Captain Angelos.
Commander, we must not abandon this sector to the traitor legions. I am headed to Calderis to discuss the matter with Diomedes. Continue to oppose the Black Legion. Angelos out.
Gabriel is correct. We must continue. We must find the traitor in our ranks.
Blood Ravens, hear me! I am Aragoth the Pillager, Master of Hounds, the Lash of the Black Legion. You and all your kind are cowards, lowly lickspittles. You must be emulating that pile of bones you call an emperor. You are as dead and useless as him. I am destroying your worlds, Blood Ravens, yet you do nothing. I see your precious craft hanging in orbit above Aurelia. I am here. Face me, if you dare.
I agree, Commander. We cannot allow him to call us and the Emperor cowards. When we strike at this madman, there can be no falling back or tactical withdrawals.
Have you mastered your fear at last?
We know no fear.
Ravens are clearly fearless in your hurry to leave the sector. The courage with which you show us your hindquarters does your Emperor proud.
Turncoat scum, I will kill you here and now.
Very impressive. You have more steel than the rest of your mewling chapter. Rejoice, brothers! Your slavery to the false Emperor ends today.
The only thing ending today is your worthless life.
Yes, and to the void with orders and niceties. But not quite yet, little Blood Ravens. First, a test. Make your way to my chosen battleground. Alphas, open the portal!
Yes, Lord.
Ah. next portal!
Yes, Lord.
Coward! You will not escape!
Commander, look. A way forward. We can finish this yet.
There is a shrine ahead. It is sure to be well defended, but securing it would aid us greatly.
alive, brothers.
Thank you. target acknowledged.
Your running is over, traitor. Now you die.
Hear some words, Blood Raven. Now show me deeds. For you, Blood Ravens! No one! No one!
Feeds on them. Kill the heretics to weaken him!
A fitting death for a leader of traitors.
True, but what game is Eliphaz playing?
Bah, he is greedy and honorless scum. He saw his chance to gain power and he took it.
And the prospect of Eliphaz with more power somehow reassures you?
Commander, another transmission from Captain Diomedes of the Honor Guard. He has declared Gabriel Angelos a renegade, and orders our return to Calderis. I have also uncovered additional information about Apothecary Galen and his expedition aboard the Judgment of Carrion.
Blood Ravens, take heed. For the grievous sins of refusing chapter orders, spreading heresy, raising arms against his one-time brothers, and stealing relics, arms, and artifacts from the chapter, Gabriel Angelos is hereby declared an enemy of the chapter and sentenced to death. The renegade Angelos has fled, absconding with the battle barge Litany of Fury. I, Captain Apollo Diomedes, issue this declaration with full authority from Azariah Kyrus, Chapter Master of the Blood Ravens and Keeper of the Librarium. Knowledge is power. Guard it well.
The log entry which played when you activated the logic engine aboard the Judgment of Carrion was only one of many in the engine's cogitation archives. Listen to these additional entries.
The Emperor has granted us a miracle. Guarding the corpses of the brothers lost aboard this derelict, we have found a survivor. Librarian Kyrus is restored to the chapter.
And this entry, sometime later.
Bonaparte fell today, killed by another demon of the Dark Gods. All our exits have sealed, and our beacons have failed. We are trapped. Kyrus's psychic powers have saved us several times already. But how can he defend against the voices I hear in the darkness? How can any of us?
The rest of the log is protected by ancient encoding rites, and these are strikingly reminiscent of the rites masking our traitor's identity.
And this is the same Kyrus?
Who is now Chapter Master and Chief Librarian of the Blood Ravens.
Emperor, preserve us.
What happened to Galen himself?
He serves with the Chapter Honor Guard.
Commander, we received word from Meridian. The Imperial Palace has fallen to the Black Legion at House Fandis. Governor DeRosa has been captured or killed.
Her death is ours to atone for.
Commander. The judgment of Carrion's logic engine confirms our suspicions. The encoding rites used by our traitor and in Galen's logs both bear a marked resemblance to those of the Chapter Honor Guard. With a copy of their codes, I could finally identify the traitor. Commander, to finally identify our traitor, we must obtain the transmission codes of the Chapter Honor Guard. To do so, you must penetrate to the heart of the Blood Raven's firebase and destroy the stronghold of Captain Diomedes. This will trigger an automatic signal from his battle barge, from which I can gain the codes we need. Between us and those codes stand both the Honor Guard and our own brothers from the 3rd and 4th Companies. The entire area is patrolled by our chapter brothers. They will fire on us without hesitation. Only stealth and non-lethal attacks can prevent bloodshed. Diomedes has established a perimeter of satellite bases. Field generators and automated tarantula sentry guns are standard issue for such temporary positions.
Captain Diomedes adheres to the chapter's tactical doctrines. The Codex calls for a tactical feint when a satellite position is destroyed. Nearby forces fall back to a strong firing line, either drawing their attackers into the teeth of bolter fire or calling in artillery. If we destroy the field generators, we can use this to push through the perimeter without killing Blood Ravens. Proceed cautiously and target the field generators. We are here to recover data, not kill Blood Ravens. Forward while the way is clear.
Enemy combatants in the field.
They fire upon us and we shall return!
I suppose. Shall I kill you now?
Incoming artillery strike! Clear the target area!
Lord Diomedes. The brothers of his retinue, they serve chaos as well.
And Diomedes himself, has he fallen?
No. But his pride blinds him.
Thrones.
To preserve the chapter. You abandon our worlds to the Black Legion. You surround yourself with heretics like Galen.
Do not lecture me, Sergeant. I follow the orders of our chapter master, Cyrus. You are the only heretics I see here.
Have Cyrus and Galen told you of their time on the Judgment of Carrion, Captain? Have they shared stories of the deaths of their brothers? Or the demonic voice of Ulcair that plagued them?
Where did you hear that name?
From Galen, Captain.
Go from here.
Commander, I have recovered the codes we needed.
So, who is the traitor?
The decoding rites needed to identify him are not yet complete. The codes did allow me to uncover additional data from the Judgment of Carrion, however. I believe I know where the Black Legion's true base of operations is hidden on planet Aurelia. The Honor Guard's codes unlocked a great deal from the Judgment of Carrion's logic engine. This record from Apothecary Galen seems especially relevant.
Librarian Cyrus grows more morose by the hour. He is a mighty asset against the things lurking in this ancient space hulk, but he does little to keep our faith strong. At morning prayers, he recounted a great battle on a lost world named Aurelia. A terrible demon beset this planet and summoned mighty warp storms. Blood Ravens faced the demon in a terrible battle at a chapter keep. This should have inspired us all, but Cyrus made it a tale of woe. He described his brothers dying one by one to bind this demon, but called their sacrifice pointless. The fiendish creature, he said, was yet free. And somehow, even before Cyrus mentioned it, I knew this creature's name, Old Care.
A demon bound in the keep on planet Aurelia. Surely Eliphas seeks its release.
I share your thoughts, Librarian. I can locate the keep's remains if we return to Aurelia.
Thank you. 1,000 years ago, in this place, Aurelia, mightiest of the Blood Ravens, battled the great Ork. With his dying breath, did Aurelia stab at the heart of the Great One. What none could slay, he wounded. And so, noble Aurelia died, with only his student Cyrus left to mourn him. Weakened, the Great One could not resist Cyrus, the hated student bound and shackled in care. Now, that bondage ends.
Get Diomedes to put a leash on Angelos.
I am not the only one who will be discovered if it comes to that. Do you understand me, Galen? Knowledge is power, as you were also fond of saying.
Thaddeus, what have you done?
He has left the Retribution, Commander. His drop pod is headed for the surface.
So young to bear the burden of a space marine.
He will grow no older, Librarian.
Commander, there is a recorded message waiting from Thaddeus.
Do not follow me. I am not proud of the choices I made, but I did what was necessary. Cyrus knew what I had done, and he let me carry on. He understood, even if you never will.
Traitor has gone to ground, Commander. Thaddeus has retreated to a fortified Black Legion base on Argent Glacier. The area is dense with enemies, but we cannot allow that to stop us. We cannot let Thaddeus escape Retribution. The Black Legion is present in large numbers. Beyond their main stronghold, they have at least 2 satellite camps. Patrols stalk the area between these strong points, ready to pounce. There may well be other defenses which we cannot detect from orbit. A direct assault is possible, but that strategy gives up our only 2 advantages, surprise and discipline. The traitor legions lack discipline. Their patrols are more interested in finding something to kill than actual reconnaissance. I doubt they have any established reporting rights or patrol rotation. If we engage and destroy the patrols quickly, their absence will go unnoticed. The same is true of the satellite camps. We can move from target to target, weakening the enemy, until we can strike at the main base and exact retribution.
Could you not just leave things be for once?
We do not overlook betrayal, Thaddeus.
You think I betrayed you? I did this to save us. All of us.
Thaddeus still has access to our Vox channels, Commander. I am marking his location on your map display, along with two other Black Legion outposts. Eliminate those to weaken the main stronghold. Keep a sharp eye out for patrols.
I do not wish to kill you, but you are not leaving me much choice. There never was a choice.
If you have pledged yourself to Ulcair, you have already made the only choice that matters. You have chosen heresy.
You were not there, Librarian. We stood on Typhon. We faced the Hive Mind. We saw the Armageddon destroyed, and we knew we could not win! I did what I had to do.
Eastern outpost ahead. Strike swiftly, lest they raise an alarm.